In the previous lecture, we found that the drag on a circular cylinder is exactly zero as predicted by inviscid theory or by potential flow theory, even with a positive gamma. We found that the drag is equal to zero. Well, this was actually discovered in the 1700s, and in a paper in 1744, a guy named Jean-Baptiste Leyrand de Alembert, he published his finding that potential flow predicted a zero drag, or at the time, I believe they called it resistance. And he was born in, D'Alembert was born in 1717, lived till 1783. He first published this result in 1744. He publishes another paper in 1752. Let me just write some of these down. 1744 was his first publication. 1752 was his next. And then finally, in 1768, he publishes another paper with this quote here. He says, "I do not see then, I admit, how one can explain the resistance of fluids by the theory in a satisfactory manner," meaning the drag. "It seems to me, on the contrary, that this theory, dealt with and studied with profound attention, gives, at least in most cases, a resistance of absolutely zero, a singular paradox which I leave to future geometricians to explain." And by geometricians, that's synonymous with mathematicians. So here he had worked on this for, here's a period of 24 years, and was stumped by the fact that you get zero drag out of this solution. Now, what's surprising is that the lift that was coming out of this was very close to what they were getting experimentally, but the drag, they knew that drag was non-zero. You know, if you put a spinning cylinder in a flow, you get some non-zero drag. And so they were stumped, and this affected the work of Euler and others who are working on similar things here with the Euler type equations and potential flow. They were just so stumped, and you had the experimentalists who were saying, no, drag is non-zero, and you have these mathematicians who have worked through this and say, we don't know what we're doing wrong. We've been so careful with this theory, and we still are getting zero drag. And so this wasn't really understood until later. The work of Navier and Stokes and Prandtl, we were able to piece together what's going on here. And basically, the bottom line is that inviscid flow will always predict zero drag on a two-dimensional cross-section. And it doesn't matter what geometry you're looking at. If you have some flow coming in on an airfoil, for example, and you look at the streamlines over this and you integrate the pressure, it will always give that drag is zero. And so now today we understand that actually drag comes from viscosity in the boundary layer. It's the shear stress on the surface. So if we zoom in on the surface of this, we actually have some boundary layer here where that velocity slows down as it approaches the surface and is exactly zero at the surface. And the shear stress on that wall, remember, is related to the slope of the boundary layer in the limit as we approach the wall. And so that shear stress, if you integrate that along the surface, that is the only drag component for a two-dimensional cross-section. Inviscid theory, or potential flow theory, says that the drag is actually exactly zero. And remember, we dropped out the boundary layer effects in the development of potential flow theory here. So what was surprising to the mathematicians is that the lift predicted by potential flow was extremely accurate, and that's because that's dominated by pressure forces, not shear forces. But the drag from potential flow comes out to be exactly zero for a two-dimensional section, and that's because drag for a two-dimensional geometry is exclusively based off of the shear stress on the surface.